Hi and welcome back. So today is the 7th of September 2016. I'm attempting to record on my Samsung Galaxy tablet, so hopefully the quality is better than using my laptop. However, I'm still seeing my reflection in the whiteboard behind me, so we'll see how we go. Not sure about this lighting either. We might have to do something about that. So my first video that I posted, I talked a bit about, well, actually it was just a general introduction really, I didn't talk much about anything, it was kind of a blab fest where I had no purpose to what I was talking about. So I kind of wanted to talk a little bit more about who am I, and how did I get here, and a bit more information about what I've experienced so far. So a bit more about who I am. So as I mentioned in the first video I posted, my name is Heidi. I live on the Sunshine Coast in Queensland, Australia. So the Sunshine Coast is just north of Brisbane. I live actually near Bribie Island, so I've got a nice lifestyle. I work from home. I work for a large telecommunications company, which probably for all Australians is obvious who I'm talking about. And I work in human resources. I'm actually really fortunate I get to work from home. So I'm actually in my home office when I'm filming this. That is great in terms of I get to wear business attire from the waist up and I can wear my pajama bottoms and no one knows when I'm in a meeting. I get to have like a video conference. All my calls are made like through a video call, so I still actually get to see all of my work colleagues and stakeholders, which is nice from a social perspective, but obviously I don't have colleagues that I turn to during the day and have a conversation with. I have no one that, you know, I get up and go for a walk into the city to, you know, either do some light shopping or go for lunch or anything like that. So I'm actually very, I'm a slob. I don't do anything. I literally just roll out of bed, put on a work shirt, come into the office, my office here, work. Sometimes I don't even like break for lunch. I just work all day. And then at the end of the day, I walk back to the other end of the house and my husband has organised dinner and sit on the couch or something. Sometimes we go to the beach, which is really nice. I've actually gotten to the point now where I'm so overweight that even going to the beach is really, it's a hard slog. It's actually kind of getting painful to be walking long distances now. I find the pain actually in my back. I know a lot of people have problems with their knees. Mine's actually in my lower back. I think it's just because I literally sit all day that I just don't have good back muscles anymore to sort of hold me up. Plus I slouch, that's not good. So working from home has its perks for sure. But it's also got its disadvantages in that I've become very sedentary and, I think I wore a pedometer last year, I think it was, and I was like, I some days I seriously had done less than 200 steps. I think the only reason it was, you know, close to 150 or something was because I pee a lot, because I drink a lot, so I had to walk to the bathroom a lot, and that's pretty much it. It was pretty eye-opening in terms of how little exercise I was getting. The other thing, and I just mentioned then that my husband looks after dinner, so obviously I'm married. We've been married for 8 years? I can't even remember. How bad is that? And he does the cooking, the cleaning, the grocery shopping, so he's far more active than I am. He does, you know, he mows the lawn, he does all the repairs on the car. He's far more active than I am. And again, it's one more thing that I don't do and therefore adds to my sedentary lifestyle. I also have a sweet tooth and a savoury tooth. I have both a sweet tooth and a savoury tooth. I'm cursed. And I definitely eat my feelings. So I reward myself with food and I comfort myself with food and I relieve boredom with food. Yeah, food is just, unfortunately, I don't associate food with just hunger and survival. I associate it with all sorts of emotions and needs on a well-being level. Anyway, so what else can I tell you about me? So I already mentioned, I think in the last video, I'm 35. I'm 5'8". I weigh 188 kilograms, which is, I think, 417 pounds. I've really got to check that. At my my lightest adult weight was 75, around 75 kilos. I sort of hovered around the 75 kilo mark, which is at the higher end of the healthy weight range for my height. I've got broad shoulders and, you know, wide hips and everything. So I think that that was actually a pretty good weight for me. I don't actually have any belief that I will get back to that size. I'm not going to say I'm ruling it out entirely. I'd love to get back to that size, but I just don't want to set myself up for, I don't want to set myself up for failure. I want to set a realistic goal, something that, you know, even my surgeon has agreed is achievable. And that way, anything beyond that is a bonus. So, I'm hoping to get to 99 kilos. That way I can say I'm under 100. So let's just call it an even 90 kilo loss. That would be great. I think, you know what, when I say that, and it's kind of funny, I was actually talking to my sister today, and I said how I wanted to lose like 90 or 100 kilos. And as the words were coming out of my mouth, I was just thinking, oh my God, that is like probably almost double what she weighs now. Like, my sister is quite petite. She's probably only like 5'6" or something. 5'5"? Gosh, I don't even know how. She's shorter than me, obviously. And she's very petite. She's got a very small, slim frame. Yeah, and I reckon that what I'm saying I want to lose is probably double what she even weighs. So I would have like two of my sisters to lose. Such a strange thought. Even when I was putting on the weight and I reached that point where I was double the 75, obviously 150, I used to talk about losing 75 kilos and being 75 kilos again and being half of Heidi, hence my channel name, Half of Heidi. And it sort of became this thing for me to now know that I need to lose more than that 75 that I thought I had, you know, planned to lose. It's more than half of Heidi now. It's two-thirds of Heidi, no. but it is, you know, more than half of my weight is what I have to lose. So it's significant. I'd hate to be put in one of those bod pods where they see what percentage of fat you are. I think mine would probably be up around the 70% fat or something. Why am I laughing? I shouldn't laugh. Anyway. So what actually happened? Like, how did I get from 75 kilos to 188 kilos? I was a chubby kid. My sister was the petite one. I was the chubby one. definitely didn't have a fast metabolism. I was actually very active. I played a lot of sport, swam a lot, but I just didn't seem to have the same metabolism as my sister. And I wasn't, I mean, I was overweight, but I wasn't obese by any means. I probably realized in about grade 5 or 6, so maybe I was 10 or 11, I realized that I was bigger than other people like my age. And my mum had started Weight Watchers, and I asked if I could go with her and lose some weight. And I think I may have lost like 5 kilos or something on Weight Watchers. But even then, I feel like because I was very tall for my age and like big frame, I think I just always felt a lot bigger than my friends and the people in my grade and all that sort of stuff. In high school, I definitely gained some more weight. I probably, at my heaviest, went up to around 90 kilos. I wasn't there for very long though. I sort of got there, and the teasing and bullying and everything, because the kids are just awesome, started, and I didn't want to go through that. And again, I was still a very active, like very active person actually. Again, lots of sports and swimming and, but yeah, I just could never seem to, like I could have the same food as my skinny friends, and I would be overweight and they wouldn't. And it just never made sense to me. It was just the way my body was. So I started walking and exercising and all that sort of stuff. And I think I probably got down to about 80 kilos or something like that. And it wasn't until after high school, when I was about 18, that I became really obsessed with losing weight. So yeah, about 18, 19, I became really obsessed. I was probably like a size 16. And I starved myself, is the reality. I worked out every day, and I starved myself. And what was really, what I find strange was how little I ate and how much exercise I did, and yet I always stayed in the top end of the healthy weight range. Like I never looked anorexic, absolutely did not look anorexic. I looked, actually looked really healthy, despite my really unhealthy approach to eating. At the time, I only ate every third day, and what I would eat was basically, I'd eat a dinner, but it wasn't like a proper dinner. I'd avoid meat and basically eat a salad and sometimes have a bit of bread, and then every day I would be working out, exercising, walking, running, and everything. So it became very all-consuming, and because the scales never went down, it was really disheartening, really disheartening. And I could put on weight really easily, but I couldn't lose it, which it just seemed so strange to me. Anyway, so I stayed that weight until I was about 22, 23, maybe. My sort of early 20s is where my life, my life timeline becomes a bit of a blur. And I'll explain that in another video, but, yeah, I stayed that way until about then. I then started having some medical problems, which made me basically just go stuff dieting and exercise and all that sort of stuff. I need to focus on this now. And yeah, as a result, that's it. You know, 10 years ago, that's kind of just when the weight just started creeping on. And yeah, 110 kilos later, Christ, that's scary saying that, here I am. This is me. I think I should probably leave this video there just because I've reached the 15-minute mark. I might record another video right now, actually, and talk about my medical issues and how that contributed to my weight gain. So thanks for watching. Leave a comment if you feel like it. And again, ask any questions if there's anything you want to know about me. Otherwise, I will talk to you later. Bye.